One of the things we love on the road is running into people. And we ran into Robert and his wife, Melanie, here at Fort DeSoto in Florida. They're from Switzerland. And so when I saw this, I was like, you do not see this in RV parks normally when you're walking around. This thing is awesome. It really is. This is an Expedition RV. This was built in Germany. It's on an Iveco chassis, but still basically pieced together by a third-party company, right? So the four-wheel drive, the differential locks, everything that helps it go wherever it needs to go. So we're going to check this thing out, because if you're RVing in the U.S., you probably won't run into many of these. This thing is built so well. So we got the dinette in the back, and this converts into a bed as well, right?
It could, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. So it could convert into a bed. And I love all these new doors that everybody's going to with the pop locks, keeps everything from opening up. This back door, not just the window part, but this entire back door, he's got a bike rack on the back, but it can lift up. And so it just makes this super open. It's really windy right now. I'm not going to do that. But that entire back door can open up and just open up this entire space. Roberts, how tall are you?
I don't know. What's 2 meters? In
2 meters. Six, I know you're over 6 feet. So
six.
We do feet two, and inches.
Almost six, seven, something
six,
like
seven.
That.
Okay. It's tricky. Everything. So they measure in meters. So we got to get on our phone and do conversions on everything. So he's 6'6", 6'7", somewhere in that range. So it was raised up a little bit for his height as well. Got a two burner stove, right? Sink, refrigerator,
oven.
Now this bed is huge. Look at the bed they've got over the top. Part of the way we ran into them is they have a boy like almost exactly Hensley's age. Okay, so just a few weeks younger than our daughter, also born in April, so also about to turn three. So pretty good size bathroom. You got the toilet and the sink, and the shower is actually separate. It's not a wet bath where everything's together in here. Step up coming in.
The air conditioning is...
And it's got a pretty good amount of storage. We'll look at that in a second, but it's pretty impressive the amount of storage this has underneath it as well. You were telling me, I know a lot of the weight... you want to keep things low, the heavier things low, you know, with something this tall that's being driven.
And everything is isolated, so everything you put into the storage is quite fine, even if you're minus 10 degrees.
It's fine.
So I mean, we can keep up for hours without heating here in the winter.
To get to your pots and pans and stuff?
Was there uh-huh. You can do this.
Oh, okay. Oh, wow, that's cool.
You got here.
Okay, and so there's storage under there. You've got storage in the kitchen area and everything else too. So you can't access the front if you want to. So we got a closet. You know, you've got probably as much or more closet, like hanging closet space as we do in our Airstream closet. So I mean, for the size of this is what, 19 feet?
About,
And then you've got the advantage, something like this, you can call and check, but a lot of times you can get into tent type areas that allow tents only. Sometimes they'll allow something like this to go park in those kind of spots too. So it opens up a lot of possibilities in where you can stay. I know they're wanting to go to national parks. It may help get into some of those places too. The shorter you are, the better you are. They ship this overseas, and they're actually going to be moving it around from continent to continent, and traveling, you know, traveling the world in this.
People get stuck into the decision making of what kind of equipment they need. They use all the energy and the time for deciding, and then in the end they don't decide any.
And I like the thought too, you know, people are like, well, what RV do you live in? Well, we don't really live in our RV, we live outside and we just kind of sleep and cook and sometimes recharge in our RV, but for the most part, I mean, we spend the majority of our days outside, just like today.
Okay, so one propane tank here. Didn't you say it's two of these?
It's like 10 gallons.
So one 10 gallon there.
So that's not 10, that's just like...
Okay.
I mean, with a... for the grill.
Yeah.
Okay. Is that for the grill?
And then this is a lot of storage in here.
This has got more storage in it than our Airstream does. Like underneath, for sure.
It gets under.
Yeah. Oh, look at all that storage. And that goes all the way through, doesn't it?
Yeah, it goes through. More or less, there's the heating is over there,
the
electricity part. But
So you can access the bay here or under here.
On the back, they've got a very heavy-duty bike rack they carry their bikes on. This can swing out. This is that door I was talking about that can swing up where the dinette's at behind that.
Is this more storage here?
Yeah, more storage.
Okay, so more storage there.
And,
so outside shower here. Ah,
you can use that one.
So this goes to a secondary tank for the diesel, which you're saying it's about 20 gallons is what's in here now.
Yeah.
But you can add on another, what, 30 with this or something?
30, yeah.
Yeah, so no 30. So you can get up to 50 gallons of fuel with this thing, and you can go 500, 600 miles plus with it. Check out those lights.
So there's your backup camera, right? God, you're out on this thing.
This is about the same height as our Class A, I'd say. And so you're going from here, you're going to go
down to Panamericana. And we'll see whether we'll ship or we go through Central America. We have to decide. And then Southern Africa, and probably in the end Australia.
Do you have a certain set amount of time you're doing this journey, if you wanted to, that you've got like a year or 2 years? Or
I mean, Colin is now going to be 3, so school starts at about 7. So I mean, we have a window of 4 years.
Okay.
Plus, minus. We'll see. And theoretically, we can self-school him if it's necessary, but or homeschool, however you call it.
Well, and that's the thing too, when you're doing this journey, you can create an income that's passive or something that's mobile, and you can work on the road and not have a whole lot saved up, or you can save up and just have a certain set time you want to do the journey. And then if you figure something out along the way where you can have the income on the road, that's great. If not, you know, some people just travel the United States for a year, 2 years, or do international travel for 3, 4, 5 years, whatever, and then just come back, you know, to their hometown and go back to where they were. So, but it's, you know, it's your journey. That's kind of what we're talking about. Just get out and live it. I think it's the message there. Well, I appreciate you taking the time to show this to us, Robert. There's lots of different ways to have your journey. There's not one set way. And I love what they're doing. I think it's a good fit for their family. But we'll wrap up and we'll catch you guys later.
You're playing in the pedal?